Hey everybody, it's Alex from Engineering Applied. We're going to be accelerating your career, hobby, or business with this overview of the available import tools found in Autodesk Inventor. If you want more easy to understand and practical content made by an experienced engineer like myself, make sure you subscribe to the channel, like this video, and turn on notifications so you don't miss out on any helpful content like this in the future. Also, if you're looking for a particular function, check the description for timestamps. And if you don't find what you're looking for in this video, make sure you check out the other videos within the Autodesk Inventor series playlist, because I'm confident you'll find exactly what you need. Let's get started. Okay, we are in our blank part window, and the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go up to import under the create section. And you'll notice I went ahead and downloaded some files that we're going to import already in my local file directory of choice. And I have these three file formats here because they're pretty common within the industry, but the top one is very common with CATIA. So this is the automotive and aviation industry. They use CATIA a lot. It saves their files in a .igs format. Next, we have the solid parts. So this is a really common CAD software. I'm sure most of you have heard of it. So if you're working with a vendor or a customer that models in SolidWorks, you can easily import those files with this utility. And then finally, we have our neutral step format that most, if not all, CAD software packages can utilize. So we're going to start with the solid part version, and we're just going to click on it and then hit open. So starting at the top here, we have our import type section. So the first option in the section is the reference model option. And essentially what this allows us to do is it allows us to maintain all of the links to the originally imported CAD geometry. So let's say, for example, we're importing this DC equipment fan and another department is actually changing the design of that fan that we've imported. Well, we can auto update that design because it's linked back to the original file. So this is really useful if you're working with multiple teams, vendors, whatever, and you want to auto update those designs in your local model. Next, we have our convert model option. So what convert model allows us to do is it allows us to break all of the links to that originally imported file and then modify it at will without worrying about any links potentially still being there. So if you're just importing geometry and you want to create a new part number for it or just modify it completely, this is what you would want to use. Moving down to our object filter section, what this allows us to do is it allows us to select what design features we want to keep in our newly imported CAD geometry. So let's say, for example, in my source model, I have surfaces, but I no longer want the surfaces in my new model. I can deselect that and so on and so forth. So we'll leave that alone there. Next, we have our Inventor length units. And essentially what this does is it allows us to define the units as we import our CAD geometry. Now, in this case, you'll notice that this area is grayed out, and that's because we are already in a part file where the units are defined. In my case, they're defined as inches by default. It could be different for you. It just depends on what you're using. So the way to use this is if, say, for example, you're at your home screen, you can actually open this CAD file from here. So let's say we want to open a solid part, we'll hit open. And now you'll notice we have that option to change the Inventor length units. So you could leave it from source, but generally you want to take complete control over the units just in case the source differs from what you actually want to use. So just keep that in mind. For this next option, I went ahead and canceled out of those other windows so that I can show you an additional option we get when we import a .igs file or something that's composed of a series of surfaces that are stitched together. So what we can do is we can go to import, and we're just going to click on this .igs variant, click open. And, you know, we've already covered this stuff up here, but you'll notice down here, we have a part options menu. Now with the part options menu, in this case, we have three different options. We have individual. So I'll go ahead and execute this. But essentially what this does is when we import our part, it keeps all of the individual surfaces separate. Now, if we just undo that, and we go back to import, select the same file and hit open and switch it to stitch. What it does is it stitches all of those surfaces together and it creates solid bodies out of that. So now we have our two solid bodies, the actual fan blades and then the casing for the fan. So let's undo that once more, go back to import, select .igs and click open. And now if we look at composite and click OK, essentially, all it does is it still keeps all of that surface geometry there. So you'll notice it's transparent and it's like sort of an orange yellow color. So this is to signify that there's still surfaces there, but it just combines all of those individual surfaces into one composite entity. So depending on what you're trying to accomplish, you have a few different options when you see this. Now, most of the time, people will typically just import that surface geometry and create solid bodies out of it. But if you want to do some surfacing operations or create some complex contours with the original surface geometry, then you would leave it, you know, as just a series of surfaces. So again, depending on what you're trying to do, you can play around with that as, you know, as you will. Let's jump back into our import function once more, because I want to discuss the select tab. So if we go to import, and for this example, I'll just use the set file. It doesn't really matter what we use in this case. We'll go to select. We'll click load model. And essentially, this allows us to select or deselect various aspects of the imported geometry before we actually do the import function. So let's say, for example, I wanted to get rid of the blades here and the fan because I don't really need it for my design. I only need the mounting locations of the casing. So I could just click this little plus sign here and it removes it. And we can also add or remove things from this little status section. So I select what I want to add or remove, and then I can just hit this little plus or this little dash here. So I'll leave the blades out of here and I'll just click OK. And now we have successfully imported our CAD geometry using the import tool. That concludes this segment of the Autodesk Inventor part creation module, where we took a look at the available import tool. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and turn on notifications to stay up to date on future content that will help you reach your goals along your journey. And of course, don't hesitate to leave a comment or reach out via my website contact page and let me know if there's anything else you'd like to learn about or see on this channel. I love sharing my knowledge and experience with the community, and I cannot wait to see all of the positive impact you'll create out in the world. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again soon.